What is up, guys? Yes, it has been a while since I last took you on a ride with me in my Rx8, but here I am and here you are, and let's get down to business. So if this is your first time watching Driven by Madness and like to watch Rx8 tips, awesome DIYs, maintenance videos, ownership videos, and much more, then definitely consider subscribing. So in this video, we're gonna talk about 10 ways to make your Rx8 more reliable. And yes, that is possible, but it's gonna take dedication and money, at least in the beginning, because like every big investment, the beginning is always the hardest part. Then as you go along the way, it gets cheaper and easier. And the first most important thing to do is to check the compression of your engine, because checking the compression lets you know how much life there is still left inside your engine. It is wise to do it before you buy the car, but you can also do it after, as long as you do it before you start having problems. You can do a compression test at home. I'll even post a link in the description to a video that shows you how to do it, or you can take your car to a mechanic and have him do a compression test. The price of a compression test, if you take it to a mechanic, is around 150 to 200 euros. But if you... Damn, that booty. Oh. But if you do it yourself, it's considerably cheaper. I post a link in the description to a video that shows you how to do it, so you can try it yourself.
The next thing is sticking to a rigid maintenance schedule. Since the Rx8 is different from other cars, it also requires a little bit more attention to make it work under optimal conditions. And missing or prolonging your services can mean a lot in terms of reliability. Maintenance itself is really easy and quite cheap, but if you fail to stick to the maintenance schedule, replacing parts gets quite expensive. So look up your service book and catch up to any overdue services. You can check my video on the Rx8 maintenance schedule to get a better idea of what to change and when. The link will be in the description. The next thing on our list is using high octane fuel and pre-mixing, or better, install a sewn oil adapter. The problem is that the dirty stock 4-cycle engine oil is being injected into the combustion chamber, increasing the likelihood of carbon buildup and apex seal failure. To solve this problem, you can disconnect the metering pump altogether and mix 2-stroke oil with gasoline. This process is called premixing. But if you chose to premix, you must use a higher octane fuel to cope with the mixture, and replace your cat with a midpipe to avoid clogging it. Never use low octane fuel because it will cause damage to the engine. 2-stroke oil is an effective lubricant that burns clean and leaves behind almost no residue or deposits. However, the best option to give your engine an increased and clean lubrication is to install a sewn adapter. This adapter allows you to use the stock metering pump, but supply it with clean 2-stroke oil that you can fill up in the engine bay instead of mixing it with fuel. And the clean 2-stroke oil will not be prone to clogging the oil injector lines. I'll post a link in the description where you can check it out. Next up, you have to maintain and possibly upgrade your cooling system. We've seen that heat is a major issue in the Rx8, so you want a fully functional cooling system to cope with it. That's why you must flush your system every 2 years to keep it fresh. In addition to that, you can upgrade your radiator with a performance one like the Koyo one. I will post a link in the description, and you can also do some tuning with Mazda edits or similar systems to adjust the trigger temperature so your fans run more and your system stays cooler. Alongside the radiator, you can also upgrade your oil cooler, because it relies on natural airflow from your car's movement and they have no electric fans to assist them. And since they are close to the ground, they get damaged pretty quickly. The link of the cooler will be in the description. Next up, you have to inspect your exhaust gases to see if there are any issues with the engine. You need to pay attention to white gases that don't go away after 1 or 2 minutes, and also bluish gases. If your car was stationary for some time, it's normal to have white gases when you start it because of condensation. But if the gases don't go away, you might have a problem, so keep an eye open for that. The next thing is to fix the check engine light when it comes on. I strongly suggest you get one of these OBD2 scanners and use it to read codes when the check engine light comes on, so that you'll know how bad it is and how fast does it need to be fixed. This way, you'll keep your Rx8 components running in optimal condition and avoid a chain reaction of problems. Moving up to number 7, keeping your ignition system in optimal health. And by ignition system, I mean the battery, the starter engine, spark plugs, wires, and coils. You want to know when was the last time they were replaced, and replace them every 4 years. Otherwise, your startups will get slower and slower, and the engine will get sluggish, misfire, and all kinds of things. There are two kinds of ignition kits you can use. The OEM one, which is cheaper, and the BHR one, which is a little bit more expensive, but it's worth the money because it lasts longer. And if you have a first generation RX-8 with a stock starter engine, change it with a stronger operated one, because the stock one is too weak to maintain a healthy and strong ignition system. Number 8. Regularly redline your engine and seafoam it to reduce carbon buildup. Carbon buildup occurs normally when fuel is getting burned and also from the oil metering system, but it can increase if you drive your engine at low RPM or do mostly seated driving. So for this reason, you want to redline your engine if not every time you go for a drive, at least every second time. Alongside this, you can seafoam your engine to clear out carbon deposits that obstruct the airflow. You can seafoam it every 2 years or maximum every 4 years. I'll post a link in the description to the seafoam alongside a video that shows you how to do it. Number 9. Remove the catalytic converter and O2 sensors if you want them to work and last. The rotary engine generates an insane amount of heat, and this causes the exhaust to be extremely hot, and the result of this heat is a premature failure of the catalytic converter, and I know something about that, believe me. So buy a D-Cat, install it, and when you have your vehicle inspection, put the cat back on to pass emissions and then reinstall the D-Cat. I'll post a link in the description if you want to check them out. Also, replacing your exhaust system with a high flow one will increase the efficiency of the exhaust system and will also reduce the exhaust port temperatures. A higher efficiency exhaust dumps heat more rapidly, thus reducing its buildup. Next up, let the car warm up before driving it. This way, you'll make sure that the engine and all the fluids are in optimal operating condition. Also, never shut down a cold engine if you have a weak ignition system, because this way you can flood your engine. And there you have it! 10 ways to eliminate most of the problems that the RX-8 throws at you. And as I mentioned, all the links to the videos and items are in the description, so make sure you check them out. So guys, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a very big like and hit the subscribe button to see more videos just like this.